Hi everyone, today is the grand unveiling of the BBC Symphony Orchestra profile triggered by the Elgato Stream Deck. Hi and welcome to another video. My name is Euan and welcome to Euan Smith Music and welcome to all the new subscribers that have joined us. I know a lot of you view these videos from America and also the UK, and of course welcoming all new viewers who have really helped support me by subscribing and of course clicking the bell notification to be kept up to date when videos like this one go live. And of course it's been a busy old time. If you stick around later on in the video, I'm going to be showing you how you can make your own apps if you wanted to design your own key press triggers with the Stream Deck and not just in Logic but in any software package, and then you'll be able to then hopefully share these as well. In the BBC Symphony Orchestra library, the mode switching feature has just gone live within the past couple of weeks, and I have been experimenting how you can change between modes, not just within the tracks, but also globally across the whole project that you are doing in Logic. And good news, this Stream Deck profile allows you to not just change between Core, Discover and Pro within one single instance, one single track, but it will also convert the entire project to whatever version you want. So if you are someone that works with a young or emerging composer who's been using Discover, when you import their files, you will be able to, using a Stream Deck, be able to click with one switch and the entire project will be able to change over to Pro or Core and vice versa. And that's one thing that I've been testing, so hence why the delay to putting this video up has been something which has taken me rather a long time. The video you're going to be seeing today is quite an in-depth tutorial video, but also there's some extra things for you to get excited about toward the end. So I would urge you to watch the entire video right the way through, as I'll be showing you all the different elements of the Stream Deck profile, which I have made not just for the XL, but also for the standard size 15 key Stream Deck by Elgato as well. Also a note to say that this video has not been sponsored by either Spitfire Audio or Elgato. This is purely for trying to create something for you, the community, to be able to use, and hopefully you will gain quite a lot of insight through this video and also the tools that I have made as well. So the idea of the profile is you can switch between modes in the new BBC Symphony Orchestra sound library, and you can also switch articulations. So you can jump all the way from the end of the articulation list with one key press all the way back to the beginning, and I'm going to be showing you how to do that. So without much further ado, let's get on and let's have a look. So first things first, what you should do is you should go into the Go menu on Finder, hold down the Alt key of your keyboard, and then go into Library. This is going to allow you to access the Services folder, where you'll be able to see that I've got quite a lot of apps in here already, and these are ones that are also available in the download as well. We're going to be focusing on making sure that you can transfer all the contents of the Stream Deck folder, which are these four folders here. You want to go to the folder that says Copy Contents into Library, then Services, and that's this folder that we've just used here. So what we need to be able to do is to go into Library Services, double click on there, copy everything, so don't drag it, but copy everything in there into Services. Now in order for these apps to work, we need to be able to go into our System Preferences. We need to be able to go into Security and Privacy. We also then need to be able to go into Accessibility, and we need to allow all those apps to be used. So what you need to be able to do is, if you haven't already, you need to be able to unlock, click here to put in your system password. Then once you've done that, then you click the plus icon, and then you then look to see the Services folder. I've added in all the apps here. So once you've done that, make sure that you've got permissions for the Stream Deck app and also Logic Pro X as well, because those will allow the communication between the Stream Deck, Logic Pro, and also the apps that you've just put into the Services as well. Once you've done that, click the padlock, and then that's you good to go. If you want to be brave enough to try out your own version of the apps, indeed make up your own, then the process is fairly straightforward. It took me a few goes, but eventually I got it right. Just make sure that you duplicate and save as a new version rather than overwrite what's already there. load up logic. So there are different versions, the template for different parts, different elements of the sound library. In this case, you can have each single instrument, but each instrument has an instance of those articulations. Let me give you an idea. Click on the plugin and you'll be able to see the bottom here. You've got all the instances of all the different techniques. Usually you would just click with your mouse which ones you want, and then of course shift click with the ones if you want to select in more than one. But with the Stream Deck, what you can do is you can then select one of these articulations without having to move your mouse or click the screen. The apps that I have installed do all that for you. These apps also work in Core, but they do not work in the Discover mode. I am working on something for that, so hopefully there'll be something soon to help you with that as well.
Keep watching, because I'll be helping you and showing you how to do all this later on.
Once we're in Logic Pro, we need to be able to import the key commands file, which I've also included in the folder that I showed you earlier on. What you need to do is to open key commands, and then you want to click the little cog on the left hand side here, and there is import key commands. Once you do that, you need to be able to go to the desired folder that you've downloaded, Logic Pro X 10.5 key commands. There is a file in there. Once you've opened that, you'll then be able to use the hotkeys that I programmed into the Stream Deck profiles for you to be able to use, not just with Logic, but also with the app as well. The key commands that were included in 10.5 are also included in the Stream Deck profile as well, so it's well worth a check.
You're doing really well. Keep going. I know it's a lot to take in, but trust me, it was a massive minefield for me as well.
Once in the Stream Deck software, click the cog at the top right hand side and you will see preferences. Click on profiles, and at the very bottom there's a little downward arrow here. Here that you can have the option to import your Stream Deck profiles. Click on that and then it opens up the folder. You'll then be able to see the options here within the folder that you downloaded. There are two. There are a 15 key option and a 32 key option. And then you'll see they're quite large for the Excel. That's because I've got numerous menus over as well. So that's an option which I'm hoping to streamline in the future, but for now it worked really, really well. And as you'll see, when you navigate around that profile, it works really nicely when you load up certain folders. Go to the edit menu, you can see some of these keys will stay in the same place, others will change. Go into tools, some of the controls will change. So these are all bang up to date, and including some bespoke ones that were not included when the update to 10.5 happened. I found that they wiped the entire lot, so I had to redo the various kind of navigation options around here as well. A new addition is the link key. The link key helps you to, when you put in your plugin, it helps you to be able to keep that plugin on the screen even when you change tracks, which is really, really useful. You can see that I'm able to open and close that plugin without having to move my mouse, which is a new addition to the Stream Deck profile, a very useful addition.
What now? Articulations and technique switching? Keep watching, because I'm going to show you how.
You can also see that when I've got the key that says BBC Symphony Orchestra Techniques, that's what allows you to switch between all the different techniques of all the different instruments. So if you've got a strings track open, you would open up strings. You've got the option to then open and close the plugin. Each of those buttons, by the way, you can see on the screen, allows you to open the plugin, change the technique, and then the plugin remains open. So clicking on any one of these techniques will allow you to change the technique on the instrument, and it keeps it very, very slick. It takes about a second, but it's a lot quicker than having to cycle through the menus, clicking on the technique, closing the plugin. So it gives you much more time for use for when you're composing as well.
Now, already this is quite a brain melting video, so I'm going to do a third tier, which is quite exciting. What you can do to make your own version of the apps. So if you think that the apps that you're using to trigger the techniques and also switch the modes between Discover, Core and Pro are just not quite as efficient as you would like, I will show you how I set them up so that you can have a go of trying to make your own as well.
Going to need to use a program called Automator. Now, Automator is part of every single Mac, but I'm using the version that was included with Mojave. That's macOS 10.14. It's because it allows you to create macros, and macros are quite useful because you're then able to use different mouse clicks and things to be able to help to sort out keystrokes that you're doing or different operations that you're doing. So you can actually create quick actions or apps, things like that, that will allow you to do things quickly. And of course then it allowed me to connect the app to the Stream Deck as well. Okay, so you've got here on the screen, you've got something called the application flow, and
you've got something called Watch Me Do. Now in Watch Me Do, there are different aspects which I do. You first of all have to tell the computer that you're going to be using your mouse. And so the template that I've got here, which you're also able to open as well, but beware, if you do tweak any of these apps in Automator, you will have to re-import them into the system privacy settings in order for them to be able to work. Otherwise you will get a message in Logic Studio that looks a bit like this. Underneath in the second window, there's a key set of commands that have basically said, you've clicked the window, you've actioned something, you've then clicked off the window in order for the action to stop. And that's basically what this three-part thing is. The way you do this is you click record and record within the environment, in which case it could be, in this case, it'll be Logic Studio. So what I did was I had Logic Studio open, I had BBC Symphony Orchestra open, I then also had Automator open. So if I just show you that side by side. So Automator open side by side along with the window for BBC Symphony Orchestra, which, by the way, you can move the window anywhere on the screen. It will still remember the position of the mouse within that window. What you do is you then record by clicking record at the top of the Automator window, and then over on the right hand side enacted the change, which was to select the actual technique, to then shift between the arrows at the bottom to navigate, and then to click stop on the record button. And that is basically it. Now, word of warning, please do not resize the window. Don't make it bigger, don't make it smaller. The reason being is, although it does know where your mouse is within the particular window, it doesn't know in terms of resizing that window where it will be. So if you were to make the window smaller or larger, then it won't work as efficiently. As far as I know, that you can move the window onto a second screen if you wanted it on a second screen, and it should still find it. It'd be great to get your feedback on this in the comments below. As I say, this is a work in progress. I want you to all have a go of it. Does it work and help your workflow? If not, let me know and I can tweak it, or as you've just seen me do, you can have a go of tweaking your own. Okay, that was quite involved. So you might want to download the how-to guide, which I've also included in the Stream Deck profile, which you can download in the link in the description below. That's a really good, useful step-by-step tutorial for you to be able to set up all the apps. Also, it's a really useful tutorial to help you in terms of where things are. If you would like to be kept up to date with how this and other videos roll out on the channel, then please don't hesitate to follow me on one of the social media links linked below in the description. And if you haven't already, check out my other playlists. And if there's any questions you have, please don't be afraid to leave them in the comments below, and I will get back to every single one of you that does ask a question. Let me know how you find this Stream Deck profile and also how you find this tutorial. Please don't forget to leave a thumbs up below, not just for this complete fluke of work, but also all the people at Spitfire and all of you composers in the community across the world, and hopefully we'll all learn something together. So until next time, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you very soon. The video on the top is one that I think you will love, and the one on the bottom is one that YouTube thinks you will enjoy. If you would like to know more about how to make your music masterpiece, then don't forget to click like and subscribe. See you in the next video next week. Bye-bye.